Doing this. I just tried to record without putting the microphone in front of my face. I'm tired. This has basically been one of the worst days. Not for necessarily like getting clips and stuff. Like that's gone quite well. I've actually got quite a lot done. But for actual playing of games has been appalling. I've lost, I think, every single showdown match I've had, which is quite a few, and I lost all of my impossible creatures matches. And so I came into this and I was like, I don't want to lose. This is against Nick, by the way. I'm sorry, I'm losing track of everything. You should all know who Nick is, by the way. SuperBlah. All go to his channel. Love him. Love him like Kote and like Darky. Maybe not as much as Darky, but, you know, I'm par with Kote. You can love him that much. You're allowed to love him that much. That's fair. But, yeah, like I say, I came into this match and I was like, right! I'm not gonna lose, I'm gonna fucking win, but, you know, saying that and doing that is two entirely different things, and basically, because I don't wanna, I wanna win really badly, but I'm not exactly playing well in anything at the moment, what that culminates in is I'm gonna play really defensive so that I can find out everything about this team, and then my opportunity to strike will open up. It will just present itself out of nothing. It will just materialize. I'll take it, and then I'll win. That's not the. It can work. It certainly can. But if he takes his opportunity before I take mine, then well, I'm up shit creek without a paddle. And yeah. That's the short and curlies of it. But He did lead with a Kyurem Black, and I have my Kyurem, and that's not going to work especially well. A lot of Kyurem Blacks tend to be, well, most of them are Scarf, but you do get your occasional sort of Life Orb mixes. And even then, Scarf ones also tend to have Earth Power regardless, because for some reason it doesn't get fucking Earthquake. No one knows why, but it doesn't get Earthquake, so there you go. But that's kind of what I was trying to scout for in that. I knew my Kyurem, not a good matchup against his Kyurem. His Kyurem will flatten my Kyurem because I don't have any dragon moves. That's fine, but I kind of need to scout which, you know, is he running mixed? I'm assuming he is running mixed, but I don't know how mixed is mixed. Can Bastiodon handle it? So that's kind of what I've been doing. And this bit is just, I don't even know what this is. This is like... I know I run Precious Doll Kyurem like a dick, but this is like next level dickishness. I'm trying to Precious Doll a Gastrodon. That's just how afraid and how scared I am of losing. Because I'm done. I'm crazy. Just fucking ah. Anyway, I am trying to gauge how much his Earth Power is doing, and it looks like it's doing just slightly on the knife edge of my sub, which is really fucking annoying, because if I could just get a sub up, I can start ice beaming, things can start happening. Essentially, I'm just waiting to have a sub. However, since he hasn't, like, the other thing is Gastrodons usually have toxic, you know, you usually got Earth Power, filler move, recover, and toxic. That's generally how Gastrodons function. So I was waiting for a toxic at some point, but he never actually tries it. And it's like, okay, I don't know how to feel about that. So I go into Zapdos, I'm like, is he like Specs or something? No, because Specs would do way more. But I was like, is he locked into it? Is he AV? I don't know. Let's go into Zapdos, U-turn out, and see what he goes for. I can go back into Kyurem knowing that I can handle an Earth Power. And then if he goes to something else, like Ice Beam or Scald, then I'm like, ah, that's interesting. One of the things that I really should have been trying to do in all of this, you know, kerfufflery, is probably try and get Hooper in. Because you know what Hooper does? It forces shit to happen. It moves the game along. It generally, you know, means like, right, you can stay here and die, or you can go somewhere else and we can see more things. But I don't. Because I'm a scaredy cat. And I was like, oh, what if the Gastrodon's got, like, super duper hyper beam and kills my Hooper? I need my Hooper. I don't know what I need my Hooper for, but I know I need my Hooper somewhere. Because it's a Hooper. It's great. It's not. I've already said it's not. But it's great and it's a Hooper. Now, every single time he brought his fucking Kyurem Black in, I thought, right, this will be the time he goes for the Fusion Bolt. But do I really want to go into Bastiodon predicting the Fusion Bolt or the Dragon Claw and then get hit with an Earth Power? So I go into Bastiodon, he goes Dragon Claw, and subsequently he actually goes Dragon Claw and Outrage every single, or, you know, Outrage is the last time he tries it, but he goes Dragon Claw or Outrage every single time he brings Kieran Black in, which is interesting. But I go into Bastiodon, I'm still not sure if it's going to try and Earth Power me. I might live it, I doubt it, because it is still coming off base 120 special attack, so it'll hurt. But I'm still trying to figure it out, but I sort of, you know, nut up a bit and think, okay, I'm going to be a little bit bolder. If I get Stealth Rocks up, that's Rotom Heat, that's Kieran Black, all taking damage, and they are limited, essentially. And I see here he goes for a Wisp, and I'm like, okay, are you, like, the tricky Wisp Scarf one? I've seen that a lot, that's also weird, but it works, if that's your thing. But he misses his Wisp as I go for a Toxic, and I'm like, that's gravy, now, you know, Kieran can do even more damage. That's perfect, that's what we want. He goes for a Volt Switch, and it was kind of obvious that he would try the Wisp next, and it's like, should I, you know, keep Bastion at good HP? It is one of the few things I know that might actually want to take on Kieran Black. And also, the Manectric he's also got on his team, also a thing. But he's going to go into Gastrodon, and here I start to think, all right, let's get a bit bolder. Let's get a bit bolder, a bit riskier. Let's go for a Toxic. He's going to go for a Scald. He wants burns on things. He knows I have loads of things to handle, Gastrodon. Let's get a bit crazy. And it works out, and I go for a Toxic, and I land it. And I'm like, yes, you know, progress. Very, very minute progress is being made. But that's all right. That's okay. As long as things are happening, that we're moving this along, it's glacial, but it's moving along. Two big walls have been toxic, I can get behind that. But I'm not about to sit around for an Earth Power. That would be dumb. And I know Awamola can handle it. Awamola is expendable in ginormous quotation marks because it does have Healing Wish. So if it gets the shit kicked out of him, it's not the end of the world. So I can kind of get on with that. But he's sick and tired of Awamola Mola. I don't fucking blame him. And he's going to go into Manectric. Now, I'm fairly confident, because Bastiodon being Bastiodon, he's fucking great, that he would be able to take a Thunderbolt even from Mega Manectric. I wasn't too worried about that. I can go into it. I don't have to spend my Healing Wish already. And then, I've got my Basti back. And Basti can do even more great work, despite the fact that he does have a Landorus T in there, which is its own worrying thing. I was a bit overwhelmed by his team, I have to say. But he's gonna go for the Mega, and as I thought, Basti would lift the Thunderbolt. Why? Because he's fucking great. It's just what Bastiodon does. I kind of wish he wasn't burned, but that is, at the end of the day, my own fault. I can still rectify that with Healing Wish from Awamola Mola Mola Mola, but, you know, for the time being, I'll get on with it, I can handle it, and, he is gonna go into Gastrodon. I know since Stealth Rocks are set up, I can get some cheeky Roar action in, and in comes Lando, and I'm like, fuck that noise, that's gonna kill me really, really hard. But, again, Bastiodon being the cool dude, I was like, you know what, alright, I can still play this risky, there's still a bit of, wiggle room in there. Awamola Mola, again, completely checks him, so I stay in, he goes for a knockoff, gets a crit, Bastiodon still takes it, gets a toxic off. Three dudes, toxic. Landorus, depending, can have massive last ability. Fucking fantastic. And Bastiodon is still alive to take a Healing Wish if I somehow manage to get it in. So, all in all, that series of plays, perfect, flawed, wonderful. That couldn't have gone much better. I'm still getting Stealth Rock damage, but there I go for a Roar and I let Bastiodon die. That was crucial! That was huge! You have no fucking idea how, like, I got ballsy, I thought, I don't need Bastiodon, whatever. But there was one crucial thing in the background that I completely forgot about, and it was terrible. But, again, I'm still feeling alright. I think, okay, Awamola Mola won't like Earthquakes, but it can take Earthquakes. It can Wish, and it can wait for Toxic to kill him. But I'm going to be cheeky, and I'm going to try and get Kieran in. Here is where I see that he's going to go for a U-turn. It was actually a really shit play, because why wouldn't you go for a... Well, Alright, going for a knockoff would be weird, but considering that I'm probably going to wish, you know, straight off the bat as he probably switches into Gastrodon, a knockoff wouldn't have been a terrible idea. But, we're coming back to this. Suddenly, I don't have Bastiodon. I lose one of my things that stops Kieran Black from being really good. So, I kind of have to be a bit cheeky. I go into Zapdos as a sort of weird middle ground, which will eat a Dragon Claw and eat a Bolt Strike. So that's sort of where I was going with that. It's not a great idea, because he could still pull an Ice Beam somewhere. But he goes for a Dragon Claw and then gets a crit. Now, it's debatable whether that really mattered. It would have hurt a lot. And at the end of the day, I still decided to U-turn out. Don't know why I did that. Probably should have tried to roost, but there you go. That was a poor play, I have to admit. It was not clever. So I effectively used my Zapdos up for nothing, which was a slice of fried fucking gold, I think we'll all agree, but still there for Healing Wish capabilities. It's alright. It's not the end of the world. In comes Manectric. I think, aha, I've gone for a Scald. I'll burn ya. Ho ho. Didn't burn him. In fact, I don't think I get a single burn throughout the entire game, which is, it's frustrating, but there you go. It's what I get for relying on hacks. But, again, alright, I've got Kyurem. Kyurem can handle Manectric, okay. Overheat will hurt like a cunt, but I can handle it. And it's alright. So far, I feel like I'm in control. I'm doing okay, you know? I'm rolling with the punches. I'm still waiting for my opportunity. It's going to show up. I know it will. And when it does, I'm ready. I'm going to pounce like a panther. And it's going to be amazing. But he Volt Switches out. In comes Kyurem again. We're going to do this shit a bit more. He's still got two more turns of Stealth Rocks before he goes down. So there's no real reason for him not to keep trying this stuff. But I genuinely thought at some point he will click Bolt Strike, and it's gonna fuck me up, and I'm gonna have to go back into Kyurem, and then I can try and set up a sub, and then maybe I can sort of roll my way out of that, and then get some headway going. But Albemarle will take a hit. Still goes Dragon Claw though. He really doesn't like my Kyurem. I don't blame him. At some point, especially with all the Bastiodon plays, I was gonna try and make that ballsy play and stay in. Thankfully, I didn't. But Kingdra happens. And then it's like, okay, right, he's brought it into Almolomolomola. Focus Energy Kingdra is big. It's the tits. Hitting Almolomolomola on the special side makes way more sense. So, that being said, I'm going to go into Hooper because I had the wish up and I can eat his Draco or Focus Energy, whatever he goes for, and then I'll kill him afterwards, because Hooper's a bulky motherfucker. But he goes Dragon Dance. Suddenly, everything goes out the window. Everything. One plus point is that because I brought Hooper in, I have forced him to go effectively for at least an attacking move. It gives me leeway to do something. If I was a better player, I probably would have gone Waterfall. Just because I'm fairly certain Hooper wasn't going to live a plus one Waterfall. I don't think Outrage was required, but he does go for Outrage as I leg it from Hooper. And I'm like, oh, fuck that noise. That's not working. That is not working at all. And then I go into Zapdos, and I have to sack that. So that's that dead. And now the only thing that could beat it is the one thing that can't do any fucking damage to it. Yay! I really thought that one through, didn't I? Shit. So now I have to sit here, get clobbered. That's plus one, by the way. Fuck knows what plus two or three is going to do. I think I could just about fit plus three in if I tried really hard and said my prayers for the next 5 years. But probably not happening. But fortunately, I do finally get the Outrage to end. He is confused, and maybe I could get a burn. Ah, can I get a burn? Oh, that would be good, wouldn't it? I'm not going to get a burn. But he is going to go into Kieran Black again. Still not getting that burn. Fuck. But now I can protect, see what he's going to get himself locked into. I can kind of roll with that punch. I can just scald and kill him. And then I can switch out and get regenerated to get all my health, well, most of my health back. So I can still handle the Kingdra, but I can't handle the Kingdra because next time he's not going to be, you know, as gung-ho. He's going to set up as hard as he can because why the fuck wouldn't he? And here it is again! And it's like, this is probably the point where I should have tried something. My best bet probably would have been Crobat. Even though I would have lost Alma Mola Mola Mola, I'm not saying Healing Wish, because that would be a massive waste of Alma Mola 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 Mola, but I am kind of saying I should have just gone straight for a Healing Wish and bolted straight into Crobat, because I'm sitting here desperately trying to get a Scald Burn, just because it's there and it makes me feel better, and it's not happening, obviously. I was kind of hoping at some point he'd go for an Outrage. Look, I'm trying to protect, I'm trying to see the Outrage, I'm trying to predict it. Even though it's like, in his shoe, he has no obvious reason to go Outrage. Why should he? Because there was one thing that I really didn't consider, and I don't know why it never crossed my mind. It really confused me. Because I saw that he didn't have Life Orb, so it should have been really fucking obvious. But he's Resto Chesto Kingdra. He is classic Kingdra. And now it's like, shit, I can't go into Crobat because how is he going to live a +3 anything? He didn't go Outrage there because he's smart and he knew that last time he tried that, I somehow managed to work my way out of it. And now it's just like, right, I need Scald Burns, but the Scald Burn doesn't matter. So basically, my only hope, because I played so unbelievably defensive with our Mola Mola, which is, again, one of the reasons why I really dislike it. It is just so static. And it really, like, it can stop something, and that's your lot. That's all it does. And if it doesn't force it out, then our Mola Mola, it's effectively just a substitute. That's all it is. It is a, you know, a substitute in your sixth slot. That's the way I look at it. But like I say, he set up to +6. He was done. My only hope now is he has a two-turn Outrage. I have to sack Crobat. Crobat is not getting anywhere, especially against Mega Manectric. He needs a two-turn Outrage, and then he has to hit himself as I Ice Beam and kill him. And then maybe, because I outspeed Lando and Rotom Heat, and Mega Manectric can't kill me. But he doesn't, he gets the free turn, and then I die, and I'm like, it was on a knife edge, it was only on a knife edge because I made it. Whether Crobat would have lived a +1 Outrage is irrelevant. It's the fact that I didn't try it, it's the fact that I just believed in the burn, and the burn let me down, and would have let me down even if I got it. So there you go. It's, yeah. And if I'd have kept Bastiodon, that entire situation was non-issue, because I can just use Bastiodon and work my way out of it. Anyway, this next match, he said low tier, and I was like, okay, I went and got, like, NUPU stuff, and he went and got NUURU stuff, and I'm like, ah. It probably was my fault. He did say low tier, and I was like, okay, I'll just go grab some bottom of the barrel shit, apart from Terry. I mean, come on, man. Terry, you let me down here. He missed two fucking dynamic punches. That's not allowed, Terry. You missed gunk shots, not dynamic punches. I thought I was in safer hands than that. But, yeah, because I picked a fucking Devotion, and it's just like, ah, Devotion's bulky. No, it's not. So, yeah, this is, he fists me hard, and fair enough. I literally just bought the dumbest shit, and it's like, yeah, that wasn't really gonna work out well for me, was it? Nope, no it was not. So there you go. He did say he hasn't really done any battling outside of League for a while. I was like, fair enough. I suppose we probably should have clarified it a bit better, and I don't know. Whatever, it's a thing. So I get fisted again, and it's like, alright, that's another loss for me. Fantastic. This is just going so well. I don't know what happened today. It's just everything I tried, I just lost. In fact, I'm probably going to go play some FIFA after this, and I swear, if I don't win one fucking game, I'm just going to stop. My body will just shut down. It won't be able to I need to be good at something. Jesus. Although that said, impossible creatures is a bit unfair because I know I'm shit at that. I get that. I understand that. Like, I'm not good at impossible creatures. That's the end of it. Like, I want to be, but I can't. I can't get around that. But, yeah, like I say, I've done a couple of showdown videos today, and I just lost everything. I might have won one right at the start of the day, i.e. when I was hungover and just woke up. So, I don't get that, but it's the thing that happened. I don't know. I'm tired. I'm always fucking tired. It's a problem. Anyway, this is... I'm just trying to... If I can kill the Typhlosion, I'll feel happy. More while, you fucking failure. You let me down. Why couldn't you... it's specs, is it? It's probably fucking... Yeah, it's specs because I outspeed it with Magneton. If you're wondering why I have Tri-Attack, well, that's purely on the basis that some people, like Coop, well, occasionally, I don't think he makes a habit of it, will breed for hidden powers. I, on the other hand, will not, and I absolutely 100% refuse to breed for hidden powers because, no, I'm not doing that. That, like, I'll breed for shinies because there's a tangible sort of, yes, I can see that. That is shiny at the end of it. That is a yes moment. Hidden powers are sort of like, yeah, and you've got to go do fucking calculations to see if you've got it right, and you're just rolling dice. You can narrow it down to make it slightly better odds in your favour, but it's still pretty horrible. Anyway, he apologized. He didn't need to apologize. It was my fault at the end of the day, or I don't know. It was a collective effort. But he goes and gets some lower tier stuff, and he brings me, and I'm like, oh, that's nice of you. Let's get Terry and punch it in the face, just to symbolize my competitive day in general. Except that his licky does pretty well, or me, whatever, does pretty well. So I don't know. Maybe that's the secret. Maybe I need to get some, like, weird puppet master in to just control me, and then I'll do better, but I don't know. Anyway, I'm gonna go into Morwile because I want to hit things, and Life Orb, Sheer Force, Morwile, while being shit, is okay. And I believe it's now PU, so I think it's actually because it dropped down really hard, didn't it? That's it, because Mega Morwile went Ubers. That's right. I always forget what happened to that fucker. Anyway, I have Fire Blast on mine for giggles, basically. I thought, why not? You know, it'd be like, just like Life Orb, Sheer Force Tauros. It's just fun. But in comes Marowak, and I'm like, right, this could present problems, depending on what kind of Marowak he is. I think, I want damage, Sucker Punch, and he goes for a sub, and I'm like, oh dear, he's Sub Punch. Why is everything Substitute? Why is everything I use Substitute? I Sub Cure him, because I'm a bastard, but there you go. Then he goes for a Boomerang, and it's Marowak. It's going to literally obliterate anything it looks at, because Marowak's great. I love Marowak. But, it does mean that, I am gonna have to try and pick how I kill it. I kind of went Magneton, because I knew, now that because I'm Scarfed, I will outspeed it. And, I'd like Magneton, but it's not essential, so at least the sub's gone. And then I know that Mantine will outspeed it. And I've got enough special attack investment to where I should kill it. That was the dream, anyway. And yeah, it does work out that way. I was quite impressed he has stayed in, although I was assuming he was worried I would set up a sub and then get initiative that way. So it makes sense, but I'm not fucking around with a Marowak. My team was hilariously ground weak, so I'm like, no, let's just make sure it dies. I can get behind that. As long as it's dead, then we're laughing. So, that's gone pretty well. And then, in comes Noctowl, and I don't have to care about Noctowl. I know. He goes for a Hypnosis. I'm not entirely sure why. I believe he shows that his attacking move is Nightshade. But I figure I'm gonna go for a sub, and I'll surprise him with a Toxic. And then that's his Noctowl done, unless his Licky Licky has a Heal Bell. By the way, yeah, that Licky Licky has Wish and Protect. That makes me sad, man. I hate that set so much. Licky Licky is so much more than a wishing wall. It's better than that. It's more than that. But still, I need to think of things to kill this Noctowl, and I'm like, you know what? Let's go punch it in the face! Terry! You you failed last battle. That Harry armor slapped you up hard. Kill the Noct Owl. Kill it. End its miserable existence. You'll show it. He misses a hypnosis. I miss a dynamic punch. Of course. You know, that's kind of how it goes. Terry, you need to get your monocle sorted out, buddy. You need to get your monocle sorted out. But can I do it this time? You know? He misses hypnosis, and I hit the dynamic! Ah, Terry! I punch that bitch in the face. I fuck it hard, and it was awesome! He's nearly dead, but you know what? I could switch out, I could let Toxic do it. But you know what's more fun? Hitting it in the face again! Pow! And he's dead, and I'm like, ha! Take that, foul demon! Terry hasn't got time for you! Terry. Terry, you're so good! I love you so! I was planning on leaving him for like one of the last battles, but I was like, you know what, we're day 6, we haven't seen Terry yet, let's get Terry in on this bitch and do some stuff. Anyway, Octinery comes in, Hydro Pumps, Terry fucking tanks it. He did say that he took specs off before the match, which is just like, aha, you see, the only reason he did that was because Terry subliminally told you to. You know, because that's a word. Subliminally. And, so I miss my dynamic punch again, and he decides to go into Licky Licky because he thought that, Oblivious would stop confusion. And, well, I don't know. Yeah, it's a thing. Own tempo is certainly a thing, but dynamic punch is also a thing. And, I do hit it, and I beat the shit out of Licky. And I think, right, if I kill this, I'm gravy. I've got a Duosion waiting in the wings, ready to clobber stuff. And a miss. And then he goes for a protect and gets all of his health back. And that makes me sad. But you know what, Terry, you're hit free. The protect one doesn't count, I guess. You know, I could never tell on that one. So you're hit 3 out of 7. It's not great, but I'll take it. It's not the end of the world, but then, like I say, I kill Terry, which is just sad. I can't... But now I am left with serious problems, because that kind of firepower from Terry was kind of what I needed to kill the Licky Licky, and now I don't have that, and if he has Heal Bell, I'm even more boned. On the one hand, Bastiodon literally does not give a fuck, which is great, but he does show Dragon Tail, which gives me a glimmer of hope, because it does mean if it's, you know, one-on-one, I will Toxic Stall it really easily. But in comes Duosion, and for some reason, again, I make the mistake of thinking, you know what? Duosions are always bulky. And it's like, no, it's not. No, it is not. So I get creamed by a body slam. A psychic does actually do a pretty respectable amount of damage. I was quite pleased with that, to be honest. I had no problems there. It's just now it's like Sticky Web helps me with Trick Room. Paralyze makes it iffy. So, yeah, I just go back into Bastiodon because I just want a Toxic on it now. This is, yeah, it needs to be Toxic'd, but, it's sort of like, I'm just, it's not really working out, and now Octillery's here. That's always terrible, because it's going to get the wish, and, oh god. Yeah, it's not great, but there you go. This is why we have Mantine, because Mantine will take on Octillery alright, because Mantine's great. Although he does make the smart play and goes for the energy ball, but I can whittle him down with Toxic Stall and Life Orb to the point where Air Slash might kill. Which is, you know, kind of the dream, but we'll see how we go. I do get the sub, he goes for the energy ball, and after Life Orb and Toxic, It's iffy, but it's sort of like, well, I kind of have to go for it. I can't get another sub in, so let's try it. And guess what? I get a flinch! Look at that! Yeah, it had to happen at some point. And it did. Thank God. So there you go. Still doesn't change the fact that Licky Licky effect, you know, depending on what its last is, Licky Licky, and that can win this. So it's still up in the air. But it is still doable from my point of view. It's just, it would have been really great if Terry just hit the last dynamic punch and killed the Licky, because then I'm solid gold after that. I can pull it out. Not well, but I can pull it out. So, yeah, I'm going to save Mantine because it may well come to that. We'll see what... I don't remember what his last is. But it may well come to that. And yeah, now we're going to have some lovely stally shenanigans with Bastiodon. Because I need a toxic on that fat bastard. And yeah, I do miss. He goes for a dragon tail. And I believe Mantine is going to come straight back in. Which is just... not great. I do get impatient and I do try and toxic it just to try and get this shit going because, oh god, I should not have done that. In fact, what I should have done is thought, yes, three lefties for whatever his last is. Perfect. But I don't. I toxic. I don't know why, but I did. I confused myself. I really do. A Bastion's back in. It's like, alright, why don't I just go back in a Bastion? He hasn't got Stealth Rocks up. He can keep Dragon Tailing me as much as he wants. At some point, I will probably get Toxic on him, but, yeah. Anyway, his HP is starting to get down there a bit, and I know that if I can get enough of a dent in him with Toxic, Stealth Rocks, and whatever the fuck, Devotion can kill him. It just depends entirely on what his last is. So, I think, aha, I will go for a roar on you, sir. He does go for a body slam. I guess he's just, well, actually, there's not really an awful lot he can do. And in comes Go-Go, and I'm like, oh, come on! Really? You mean the substitute in bulk up fucking Go-Go that gets Horn Leech and Earthquake is his last? And at that point, I was like, it doesn't matter how I try and finagle this, it's done. I tried, and I failed. I kind of knew that he probably had sub. It tends to be the way things go. But he goes for the sub as I go for a toxic, and that just officially, like, nail in the center of my forehead. Blood just gushing everywhere. And then, you know, kicks me down the flight of stairs with Earthquake. So now I'm a man with a nail in my head and many broken bones, but that's the way my cookie has crumbled today. It just hasn't worked at all. I kind of tried to kill the Licky. Like, I try and go into Devotion and think, maybe I can just kill the Licky, and then it's only a 1-0, and then it shows that I tried, but I don't believe I actually get to kill the Licky, because I believe he's gonna just pass the wish straight out, as he should. You know, why not? What's the point in trying to stay in and compete with Devotion when you've got a fucking Go-Go? Psychic does a decent amount, though. Again, I had no problem. Like, Devotion's, like, actual output was great, but survivability? No. I suppose that's kind of why you got Eviolate or Life Orb as your options, and I went with Life Orb, and it let me the fuck down. Like I say, even if I gotten a crit there, it wouldn't have mattered. So, I fucking lost. I lost everything I did today. And I'm gonna go to bed, and I'm gonna wake up tomorrow, and I'm gonna go do work, and fuck work, but whatever, and then I'm gonna come back, and I'm gonna start fresh. It'll be a different day. I can just leave the day of suckability behind, hopefully. Please God, it's been a long day. Oh, well. And hopefully tomorrow I'll battle Cooper and he can have his own video, and then that'll be nice. And I need to battle Robotnik at some point, and then Socrates needs to, I need to showdown with him, and I'm just tired. I'm so very tired. But thank you, Nick, you're an awesome, awesome soul. Yeah, go show him love. Love him. Remind me, Nick, and I'll put your channel in the description, even though I think you have way more subs than I do, so it's kind of irrelevant, but you know. There you go, I hope you all enjoyed, and, yeah, bye.